A charge against an Abita Springs man accused of running an international child exploitation enterprise was made public today. The charge, which includes thousands of members worldwide, was disclosed by the U.S. Attorney's Office.
WDSU anchor Rachel Wolf spoke exclusively with the suspect's mother. Rachel?
Jonathan Johnson has been in jail since last June. Today, the U.S. Attorney's Office unsealed a bill of information charging Johnson with operating two child porn websites from his home. Today, we spoke with his mother, who is saddened by what she says her son did.
I was, like, devastated. You know, it's like, oh, my God.
Cheryl Johnson still can't believe her son is capable of such a heinous crime.
It's hard. Every time I think about it, I just cry. I have a hard time working. Have a hard time dealing with it, you know.
27-year-old Jonathan Johnson is accused of running two child porn websites right from his Abita Springs home, the same home he shared with his parents.
You had no idea that any of this was going on?
No. Mm-mm. And we didn't know till about maybe 10 days later when he finally broke down and told us.
Johnson says her son admitted to the crime last May after federal agents seized some of his personal belongings, including a computer and a cell phone.
I'm upset at him and I'm mad at him, you know, for doing it too. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it's like, what's done is done. There ain't nothing you can do about it.
According to court documents, Johnson regulated membership on two websites with 27,000 members internationally, creating two categories, members and uploaders. The sites included tutorials that provided guidance to members about how to communicate and coerce minor boys into sexually explicit videos and how to avoid being caught by authorities. The sites encouraged members and uploaders to recruit unsuspecting boys from social networking sites. In all, 2,000 videos sexually exploiting young boys were found. Authorities say 160 child victims have been identified and rescued.
I'm really devastated about it, and I know he knows he's done wrong, you know, so we just have to wait and see how it's going to play out.
Authorities say Johnson and others use female internet personas to initiate communication with the boys. The U.S. Department of Homeland Security and the U.S. Postal Inspection Service helped with that investigation, which has resulted in 10 others nationwide being charged by the U.S. Attorney's Office. One is actually from New Orleans. They're accused of conspiracy to produce child porn, distribution of child porn, and receipt of materials involving the sexual exploitation of minors.
Tough case, Rachel. To read the list of charges that Johnson faces, we have the full indictment on our website, WDSU.com.